St. Paul's is not short of youth clubs, but these will not help to blunt the immigrant teenager's sense of shock. In school, they were treated equally. Suddenly, in adolescence, they encounter prejudice. Coloured school leavers from St. Paul's have to try for more than twice as many jobs as their white counterparts. The new race relations bill may help them, but in spite of it, they know that the better the post, the greater will be the resistance. West Indians come from a multiracial society, yet one in which the way of life has been strongly influenced by the English. When Indians and Pakistanis meet prejudice, they can find support in their own cultures. But the West Indians can't turn their backs on the English culture, because it's one they have absorbed, enlivened, and made their own. The St. Paul's Festival set out to remind West Indians of their own traditions. In the West Indies, few can afford the toys they see in the shops, and children make their toys together. The festival organized toy-making sessions, where children enacted a tradition that some had forgotten and others had never known. For those who will live in a state of cultural turmoil, it's impossible to know what in their background is important and what is unimportant. That which is worth keeping and that which is now irrelevant have become inextricably intertwined. Neither is it possible to separate what is the new cultural hybrid and what is the old. Dominoes is a popular West Indian game, so a dominoes tournament became a festival event. But the game had arrived for the colonizers and enslavers, then to be taken up by the West Indians and played in a way of their own.